Hey everyone, it's the start of another weekly reading vlog for the Magical Readathon. If you missed my first weekly reading vlog, I will link it up above so you can go and check it out. I've already read 3 books for the readathon, which is really exciting, and this week I'm aiming to read 3 more, but that might be a bit of a stretch because one of the books I'm reading is enormous. So the first one that I'm reading is going to be For Muggle Studies, and that's a book told from the point of view of a muggle, and I'm reading Wanderers by Chuck Wendig, and I'm reading this with my friend Justine from I Should Read That. This one isn't actually a contemporary book, which is what the prompt said, but it is set in the real world and the main characters are muggles. I think it counts, I'm counting it. It's an enormous book though, it's 800 pages long, so I don't know if I'm going to finish it this week or next week because I've only managed a couple of pages so far before I fell asleep. So I'm reading that on my Kindle. I'll give you an update on what it's about and everything later because at the moment I don't know. I'm also planning on reading for my History of Magic out. I'm going to be reading Harry Potter, which is a book about witches. I'm reading the really nice illustrated edition and I'm really excited. So I've already started this. I'm about a quarter of the way through and I'm hoping to read a little bit every night before bed. Again, I'll keep you updated on how that goes. And then there's also a book that's been on my TBR for a month now and I'm just kind of in the mood to read it, especially because the sequel's coming out and I want to recap it for Recaptains. That one is Once and Future. I think the sequel came out this week actually, so now is the right time to get around to it. I don't know if this fits into any of the Owls prompts, so I might pick a fourth book, to go with the Owls, but I'm just really in the mood to read this one, so that's my plan for the week. I'm gonna go on a 5k run now, so I'll be back afterwards and I'll let you know once I've got something to update you on. It's finally the weekend and I'm feeling so much better about myself. It's Friday morning. I didn't vlog anything yesterday because it was the last day of work before the Easter holidays, and honestly it's the busiest day of the year. We get 3 work days in one because we're trying to get all of the work out that's due on the Friday and the Monday as well, so Thursday, Friday, Monday's work. It's always chaos, and this year we managed it quite well, I think. I'm quite pleased with it. So I haven't actually done much reading. I did read a little bit more of Wanderers, or at least I started it. I don't think I started it. I had started it in my previous clip, but I've started it now. It's very easy to read. It's a very long book, but I have faith that I'm going to fly through it. I'm currently on chapter 7, which is just behind Justine. I will catch up today, I think, because I've got a 4-day weekend, and today I've not really got many plans other than Stardew Valley, Vlogilates, and I think that's it. I might do some baking, but I haven't decided whether I want to do cookies or if I just want to do some basic, I don't know, Easter egg nests. For now, I'm just going to record some videos because I've got 3 videos that I want to record: my March wrap-up, my quarterly stats, and my quarterly goals. I was going to record my Wicked Saints review today, but I'm not quite prepped for it, and it's also very early in the morning, and I haven't had coffee, so I don't think I quite have the energy to rant about Wicked Saints yet, but I will be doing that, probably recording that on Monday for it to go up the following week. I managed to record 2 videos before my camera died a horrible death, so I'm going to charge my camera battery now, and then probably, I don't know if I'll record later, I don't know if I'll still have the same sort of energy. So at least I've got 2 videos to edit now, that's good. I've just read some more of Wanderers and I'm now 10 chapters in, and we've just had the first mention of SARS and coronavirus, so that was very topical. I am enjoying the book, but I think because it's 800 pages long, it's going to take a while to get going. It's going to take a lot of effort for me to read, but that's fine. I'm dedicated and I've got a long weekend, so hopefully I can smash the book out. I'm now in my gym stuff because I am about to do a Vlogilates workout. I'm doing abs today, which is always my favorite workout, so I'm quite looking forward to it. So I'll carry on charging my camera battery while I do that, and then we'll see where we're at. I'm done with my workout. I'm gonna relax, eat something, and then go and play some, or watch some Planet Zoo Let's Plays, because I'm trying to convince myself not to buy it because it's expensive, but at the same time, it looks like a game that I'd really enjoy. I might just go ahead and buy it today. It's currently Saturday morning and I've done a little bit more reading of Wanderers, but I haven't really done much else. So yesterday, Quill and I had our spa date, which was lovely. I really enjoyed it. It was really relaxing. And then I got some kind of bad news about a co-worker of mine, and now I'm in a weird mood. So it's the morning, I'm sat outside before it gets too hot, because I think it's supposed to be 26 degrees today, which is kind of a heat wave in the UK. So I'm just reading some of Wanderers before it gets too warm, and then I'll go and make some lunch. I think today my only plans really are going to be make some chocolate nests and then do some video editing. I kind of want to just take it easy today, and obviously can't really go out and do much anyway. I don't feel like running today, so we're going to run tomorrow. Quill and I also found the Harvard University have put a few online courses up for free, so I've signed up for a couple of those and I'm going to take a look at them. Some of them are quite simple. One's a week long and it's about omens and prophecies and things, and I thought it sounded quite interesting, like something that I would want to read about, so I signed up for it. Then there was a coding one, and then the other one was the health effects of climate change, which is another topic that I'm quite interested in, so I'm gonna take a look at those at some point today or tomorrow. I think the intensive one is going to be the coding one. The others should be just interesting and simple, but that will give me something to do when I'm not working and something to work towards, I guess. I'm also working towards my YouTube channel and maybe my blog as well. But something extra is always fun. So I'm gonna carry on reading now. I'm currently 15% of the way through Wanderers, and my Kindle says that I have about 8.5 hours left, except it said I've had 8.5 hours left for the past hour, so I don't think it's calculating my speed properly, probably because I keep getting up and taking breaks. So I'm gonna read some more of that now. I'm really enjoying it. I don't really have much else to say on it. It's very topical. Corona's been mentioned, bats have been mentioned. Other than that, I don't really have many strong feelings about it, other than it's freaking long and it's gonna take me forever. I think today as well I'm going to read some more of Harry Potter, because I haven't read any of that in a couple of days, and then I might also start Once and Future if I feel like it. It depends what kind of mood I'm in, what kind of genre I want to be reading. Happy Easter. Good morning. I don't really have much else to update you on because I haven't really done much reading. I read a whole chunk of Wanderers yesterday and it's really picking up. It's getting really good. But yeah, I don't really have much else to say. So today I think I'm going to be very focused on reading. I'm going to do a recap as well because I need to post on Recaptains. I'm trying to post a couple of times a week to keep engagement up and to keep Google happy. But the reason I look like this is because I've quickly showered. Quill is currently in the shower. I don't know if you can hear that music. He's trying not to listen because I'm about to hide his Easter egg, and then we're gonna both do an Easter egg hunt, which is exciting to me because I don't get much excitement these days with being in quarantine. So I'm going to hide the Easter egg and then let him know when I'm done, and then we're both gonna look for our Easter eggs together, and I guess I'm gonna record that as well. And then obviously I'm going to get dressed because I just quickly showered while he hit mine. I think my idea for hiding the Easter egg, so far I've only got one idea, and that is to hide it in that box. I'm gonna take the books out because those are books that I'm going to donate at some point when we're allowed back out. But I thought maybe I could hide the Easter egg in there and then put the books upstairs where Quill's not actually going to look. So let me just see if this is a good idea. You're a bit wonky, sorry, but can't bother to fix you. My hair looks ridiculous, I realise this, but like I said, I was quickly trying to shower so that I could hide his Easter eggs because I really want mine. I've taken the egg out of the box, so I've got the egg and the tiny chocolate bunnies, and I'm going to put them in here. I was a bit worried that we were going to be hiding them in the same place, which would have been really awkward, but thankfully it doesn't look like he's caught on to this idea. Maybe I should just put some books over the top as well, so I'll put the egg in there and then see if I can lay some books out on top without crushing the egg. I don't want to make it too difficult because I do want him to be able to find it, but at the same time it needs to be a bit of a challenge, especially because he's just told me that I'm never going to find mine. So I feel like I should challenge him a little bit. Okay, the egg is covered up. You can kind of tell that there's something onto those books because it's not completely flat, but hopefully it won't matter too much. I'm gonna go and tell him to get out of the shower now, and then we're gonna look for our eggs. I might do my hair before we do that.
Really?
Yeah. I'm getting ideas as well, because wherever you don't look is probably where mine is.
Interesting.
We really need to wash that mirror.
Yeah, do that. Wait, no,
how would it be in there? I agree.
Inside,
yeah, it's not outside.
No, I can get this.
Okay. Yeah. Octavia's come to help.
Octavia, where is it? You must have seen something. No. Doubtful you put it in there. Okay, so I think on balance of probability, it probably is upstairs. Am I right?
Do you want me to tell you?
Downstairs.
Yeah.
Damn it. Oh, so now you're following me in here. My one's the blue one, right?
Yeah. What?
No.
What have you found?
I thought I found it, but it's actually part of the Xbox. It's not here. It's definitely not behind here. can rule that out. You wouldn't have been able to fit it under the sofa, would you?
You're in the correct room.
I'm in the correct room.
Mm.
Right, okay, don't tell me anything else.
Okay.
I can get this.
Ooh!
You're not having me on. I'm actually in the right room.
You're 100% in the correct room.
That room being the living room.
Yeah.
It's in like some sphinxy riddle.
In this weird square area.
Oh my god, where are you? Elusive egg! Am I just being really thick?
Like, no.
I must be, right? Unless you were lying about it being under the sofa.
I'm not lying.
You're lying. I forgot we weren't allowed to take them out of the box.
So that means that mine is still in the box.
I don't feel so bad about what I'm talking about now.
Oh, why did you feel bad?
What? Because I thought I'd hit it in place and it was like too difficult, but...
Okay, as long as I can reach it. Can I reach it?
Yeah, probably. My hide it down the toilet idea doesn't seem so crazy anymore.
That is crazy.
It's not crazy, it's just smart.
Now it's Amber's turn.
Well, if it turns out I'm really bad at Easter egg hunting.
I mean, you might be. I still think you beating me in Stardew Valley, it was a fucking fluke.
Well, I need to go rooting around in things, like disgusting things.
Disgusting things? Yeah. I mean... No, but I don't know what you think is disgusting in our house, Amber.
The toilet? Where are you going to put it in?
Okay, I promise you I haven't put it in a toilet.
Or the bin.
I haven't put it in a bin.
Octavia.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
We know it's not on the sofa.
I'll fix that.
What?
Climbing on furniture. Still searching. You think I hid it in the fridge?
Maybe.
I hid the chocolate where no one would ever expect to find it.
I didn't mean to hide it in.
No, you can't have like, you can't have an Easter snack before you found your Easter egg. You can't have an Easter snack when you're still on your Easter egg hunt. Yeah, because I found my Easter egg. I haven't put it in one of those drawers.
You haven't?
Yeah, just to save you time.
Okay, that doesn't count as a hint because I didn't ask for it.
Because you're too short.
I'm not that short on average height.
Oh, that would have been genius.
I know, I've got such good ideas.
Ooh, okay. See, originally, I like literally shoved it behind the water tank.
Behind it?
Yeah, so that you wouldn't be able to see it. And then I felt bad because I thought it'd be too difficult. Now I feel like it would have been deserved.
I probably would have climbed in there.
You would have climbed in there?
Yeah, I take these very seriously.
Do you reckon you can?
Not all the way in, but I reckon I could.
Do you reckon you fit in there?
Yeah, I think I won.
Why did you win?
Because I found mine faster.
I don't think you did.
I think I did.
I don't think you did.
You've only been recording for 5 minutes.
Yeah, but also you played dirty.
No, like, I didn't. How did I play dirty?
Because you took it out of the box.
Yeah, you said we could. That was part of the rules that we previously established.
Yeah, but then I forgot we said that, Amber, so...
Good morning, everyone. It's currently Tuesday morning, and I did quite a bit of reading yesterday, so much reading that I didn't bother to update you because I was too busy. I ended up finishing Wanderers, which... was pretty great reading wise. Anyway, I read around 500 pages, I think, in one day, which I don't normally do. I haven't done that in a while, so I'm quite pleased with that. In case I haven't already told you, I'm not sure if I have, Wanderers is about a pandemic. So this girl called Shana, her sister suddenly starts sleepwalking one day in the middle of the day. She starts wandering towards an unknown destination. Shanda becomes a shepherd, which means that she's following her sister, like keeping her clean, making sure she's okay. Nessie, the sister, is joined by a bunch of other people eventually as she's wandering through the states. You're also following the point of view of Benji, who is a doctor who used to work for the CDC. He's trying to figure out what's going on here. While all that is going on, there's also some kind of coronavirus slash infection that comes from bats. Or seems to come from bats. That's kind of all happening in the background. The main thing at the start of the book is the walkers who are wandering towards some sort of destination and they can't be stopped. I personally quite enjoyed it. I didn't love it by any means. I thought it had some flaws. There was an unnecessary rape scene in chapter 50, which was brutal. I think it was only there to make the rapists, to show that the rapist was an awful character, which I think could have been done very well anyway without the rape scene. So that was quite disturbing. I feel like it was a bit too long, but at the same time, I'm not sure what could have been cut out because the story was quite large. Chuck Wendig had a lot to tell. I'd probably give it 3 stars. I might do a full review on it and read some reviews during my review like I did with Normal People. It was an enjoyable book. It just wasn't anything amazing. I don't feel like I've wasted 800 pages or like hours of my reading time. So on top of that, I also read some of Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, the illustrated edition. So I'm currently on the chapter where Harry goes to find the Mirror of Erised. I stopped just after Christmas in the book, so he hasn't actually gone to the mirror yet, but he's about to. Obviously, I'm enjoying it. I might actually do a video where I'm annotating the book, not this copy, but one of my older copies, because I came across some quotes that didn't really stick out to me before, but they do now, or they did stick out to me before, and they're just quotes that I really enjoy. So I might go through and annotate. That might be something that I do. Let me know if you want me to do a video on that. I will probably do a video anyway. No one stole my idea. So that's where I'm at with Harry Potter. I might finish this one today before the end of this reading vlog. I do have work today, unfortunately. And then there's more. I also started Once and Future. I'm only 5-10 pages into this because I started it late last night when I was going to bed and then I fell asleep. So I don't really have much to say about it at the moment, but I am very excited to carry on with it and then recap it for recaptions. So I don't think I'm going to finish this one today. This one's going to go into next week's vlog. So this one doesn't actually fit into any of my owls, I don't think, but Harry Potter does. That's counting towards my History of Magic owl once I've completed it. And I forgot to say that me finishing Wanderers actually completes my Muggle Studies owl, so that's 4 owls out of 7 complete. I will be back later on to give you a final reading update because I'm starting my vlog, next week's vlog, on Wednesday, tomorrow. I'll let you know how my reading goes. Hi everyone, it's the end of my weekly reading vlog. I hope you enjoyed this video. I don't really have much else to say because I haven't really done much more reading. I've read another chapter of Harry Potter and that has been it. Since I'm stuck at home, I don't have any plans for today. So I'm just gonna end the vlog here and then get started on my next one. If you enjoyed this video, do like and subscribe and wait for my random review of Wicked Saints, which will be up soon, and also my review of Wanderers because I've decided that I'm going to do a full review on it because I've got some things to talk about. Thank you so much for watching and I'll speak to you all in the next video. Bye.